YouTube. Cheers. Still on that brown ale. Beautiful. Brilliant. Brilliant brown ale. Anyway, I've got a couple updates and things I'm doing. I'm doing a wild yeast experiment at the moment, and I'll show you a couple of pictures of that, but I don't want to take anything away from the actual video that I do on the wild yeast. I think I put a little bit on another video, but this, it's gone feral, like the wild yeast experiment's pretty... It smells a little crazy, funky, but I'm going to bottle it into a wine bottle, a pretty sturdy wine bottle, and cork and cage it, and put it away for about 12 months and see if it sort of sours up and tastes okay. I don't know. Maybe it will, maybe it won't. Maybe it'd be tipped down the drain and, well, I've lost nothing. Anyway, there's another video on here about the start of the wild yeast experiment, and it continues to this day. The other thing that I did was I built a copper manifold for my mashtun, and I haven't tried it, but my brother he missed his flight today, so he's gonna come tomorrow night. So when he gets here, we're going to do a couple of brews. We'll do the stout that I was talking about, and I've thought about doing some wood chips soaked in bourbon, just to sort of give it a bit of a bourbon barrel age type flavour and aroma, I suppose. And I'm going to do a German, Northern German Alt beer while he's here too. So I'm going to do two brews. I'll pick the brews out. I've had a look at them, and they look good. They're not too hard to do, so something that my brother can help me with, and we'll give the new manifold and the mash tun a try. I'll just show you now the new manifold and how I put it together. Yeah, this is the wild yeast experiment. You can see how it's fermenting away. Right, these are the parts that I used to get the manifold started off. As you can see, so putting it together at the bottom of my mash tun and measuring everything out. That's the end piece of the copper pipe that I bought. And then just started measuring it out and slowly putting it all together. It doesn't take much. I'm not an engineer or anything, and this is quite easy. The hardest part, I'll tell you, was cutting the slots, as you can see there, cutting the slots in the bottom of the pipe. That took me hours and hours. So there you go. That's how I made my mash tun. As I said, I'm no engineer, and I mean, if I get poor efficiency, I get poor efficiency. I'm not really too worried. I'll adjust it and make it work for me the way it works for me. I've seen similar setups done, so I'm assuming that will work. The water, I fill it up with water, and it flows through quite easily, so I'll see how we go. The other thing that I wanted to say is, when the wild yeast is done, I'll bottle it and show you that, and then I will I'll put that away, and we'll do a video later on, a long, 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 long way in the future. I'm talking about a year, and we'll do that and taste that that wild yeast beer. Okay, cheers. Have a good Friday, and I'll catch you later.